And that'll bring up Judge. Judge had his 11-game hitting streak snapped yesterday. Last 32 games hitting .411. Crowd chanting MVP. Fouled away. It's not even September. Look at those numbers. It's like a video game.
Yeah, he has put on a show here, especially recently. But, you know, if you go back, it's just not the last couple weeks. It's been the last 100 games.
I mean, you try to wrap your head around the numbers if he had just an average April. He had a bad April.
Mm-hmm.
0-2 on Judge. He's looking to have his third 50 or more home run season. Rookie year he had 52, then he had the magical season with 62. Now he's at 49 right now.
I like his chances, Michael, for the 50.
You do?
This year.
All right. But you didn't see him today. He needs you to see him.
Ah, that's a good point. But you know what? He could still have a big day. You know what? Whether you see him or not, you can usually see where they end up, and that's out in the seats.
So Gomber's allowed 25 home runs. That's tied for the third most. High fly ball. Deep left center. Doyle back. See ya. Boarding flight 50. 50 home runs. Aaron Judge has done it again. Amazing.
Well, Michael, that's 50. I'm going to give him the silent treatment because, you know what, I'm really out of words. I don't know what else to say other than to listen to you say, see it. I told you to get warmed up. We're going to be some home runs in it. I tell you, not only Judge's home run, as you look at this, he kind of got out in front and reached for it. But, boy, you know what, he stays back on it so well. That if he gets these arms extended wherever he hits the ball, yep, see ya. You know, as good as that at bat was,
four with plenty more games to go.
Again, everything there, he actually had to kind of reach for this because it was a little off speed. But, you know, when he extends and hits the barrel of the bat, the ball jumps. That's my favorite view, Michael, because just look at the fan reaction. I mean, they're just waiting for it to happen, and here we go again.
I love it. And you also see his teammates. Story of this inning, that man, number 99, goes for number 50. 50 home runs for Aaron Judge. Can you believe it? You better. We're seeing it.
Starts before the Toronto Boston game. This is suspended like a month ago, right?
Mm-hmm.
So when it was suspended, Denny Jensen, the catcher, was at the plate. And I think it was a strike. No, so it was in the second inning. Now they're going to finish the game tomorrow. Well, Denny Jensen's no longer with the Blue Jays.
High fly ball, deep right field off the bat of Soto. There it goes. See ya. Into the bleachers, a long home run. And the Yankees lead 5-3.
Michael, it's another matinee. The Judge and Soto show, right?
and that was a bomb there. That hit the back of the bullpen for his 37th of the year. 418 feet. Michael, how many times can you say these guys are fun to come to the ballpark and watch, huh?
Soto and Judge. Judge and Soto. It works. 37th home run. 95th ribby. Here's Judge. Can they go back to back? High fly ball, right field. Cave back. He's on the track. He's at the wall. Back to back. He's done it again. A two home run day for Judge. Home run number 51. And the Yankees lead.
These guys need to play in, right?
I don't know what league could hold them right now.
Wow. Just thinking, you know, before this inning started, you know, it's just too close for comfort. You're only up a run, and all of a sudden, Soto and Judge see you.
He doesn't do many curtain calls. Let's see if he gets one now. You know what that reminded me of right then? When Roger Maris hit his 61st, that same kind of, I'm embarrassed to do this.
Yep, he didn't stand tall. He got it over with. But you see Juan Soto, little breaking ball right there. And off the back wall, a bomb. And then Aaron Judge, ball away, take it away. You know what, Michael, he didn't even get that ball. But he's so strong and so good that it makes it into the bleachers. All of a sudden now, three-run lead. Looks much better for Aaron Boone.
And if you're a reliever, you're brought in here. All right, keep it one run. And I know this is a tough part of the order, and he's given a back-to-back to Soto and Judge and a somewhat shy Judge.
It's kind of like, you know, Aaron, I'm giving you a curtain call, but you know, this is what I'm supposed to do. I'm just doing what I'm supposed to do, right?
51 home runs. You know, Soto, in his first year in the Bronx, is having a magnificent year.
Yeah.
So the two of them have gone back to back now six times, tied for the most in franchise history with Damon and Teixeira did in 2009. So he's having a magnificent year. That one is drilled deep to center field. Doyle back, still back, track, wall. See ya. Oh, ho, ho. Into Monument Park. Putting on a show.
Talked about what Big G could mean to this lineup. I mean, now he's swinging the bat. You've got three guys that on any given day on one swing can put one in the seats. What a fun inning for the Yankees.
Can Chisholm make it four straight? Takes a pitch low, 1-0.
You know, it's so funny. If you watch and track his at-bats, he gets closer and closer, starts hitting line drives. Next thing you know, he starts hitting monuments.
Soto, Judge, Stanton. The way it's written up, the way you planned it.
You know, he kind of lunged the other night at that three-run homer. There was no lunge there. That was an absolute rocket, a line drive, 400 plus.